the introduction of the all partners representatives, now I invite Professor Dr. Hakan Sarı to make his presentation about challenging the stress and strategies for management for educators.
Firstly, in Turkish, teşekkür ederim. Çok değerli İl Milli Eğitim Müdürüm Sedal Büyükbey kardeşim. Biz tabii daha liseden beri yakın arkadaşız. Aynı liseye beraber devam ettik. O günden beri de sürekli iletişim içerisindeyiz. Yine Servet abimiz sağ olsun. Her zaman görüştüğümüz bir abimiz. Ahmet Hoca, Bilal Hoca. Ondan sonra ve belki de içinizde tanıdığım bazı arkadaşlarımız da var. Hepiniz hoş geldiniz, sefalar getirdiniz. Bana da böyle bir sunu fırsatı verdiğiniz için teşekkür ediyorum. Tabii Emrah Hoca bana İngilizce sunu yapın hocam dedi. Dün söyledi, ben de akşam hazırlandım geldim. Onun için kusura bakmayın, belki bazı slaytlarda anlaşılamayan cümleler, spelling mistake olabilir. İşte challenging'de büyük i harfi olduğu gibi Hakan Hoca büyük i yapmış falan da demeyin. Çünkü bunlar akşam gözümden kaçan şeyler yani. Onları düzeltiriz sonra. Tamam mı? Teşekkür ederim. Dear my close friend who is Konya Province Local Education Authority Mr. Seydar Büyük and my close friends, my colleagues and dear guests from five different countries coming for the project meeting and dear colleagues who are teachers in the Konya Local Education Authority schools. Welcome to Turkey first for forum guests and welcome to the meeting and for participation. Thank you very much for all. My presentation title is, as you know, challenging the stress and management strategies for educators. Sorry for spelling mistakes. As you can see in the slide, for example, big I letter. There shouldn't be a full stop in I letter actually, with the I letter. Sorry, this is my mistake. Challenging the stress and management strategies for educators is very important title actually nowadays, as my colleagues said that nowadays, as teachers, as educators, as managers, as gatekeepers, as administrators, as head teachers, whatever you say. Really, we have in stressful time, and we have very much stress actually caused by many factors. That's why I put my title Challenging Stress and Management Strategies for Educators. Educators are under pressure to meet the demands of running a house, household, classroom, personal concerns and responding to children in their schools. Stress is natural and can be inevitable, but stress can take too toll on your health and effectiveness as a parent or provider. Stress doesn't just affect educators. It also impacts the colleagues, students, and everybody in schools. Stress, as a definition, if you look at the definition of stress, stress can be defined is a physical, mental, or emotional response to events that causes bodily or mental tension comes from a situation or a thought that makes you feel frustrated, nervous, anxious, or angry. Sometimes stress can be a good thing. Sometimes can also be harmful. Common symptoms of stress in terms of four dimensions. For example, there are many dimensions of stress. First of all, four dimensions is cognitive one, emotional one, second one is or second dimension is emotional, third dimension is physical, and fourth dimension is behavioral. In cognitive dimension, we can see if the stress level is high, we can see some deflections on a person who can be a teacher, who can be an administrator, who can be a head teacher in the school. If we think about the emotional, cognitive dimension, we can see, as I said before, we can see some deflections on the person, personal life. For example, memory problems, inability to concentrate, continuous worries, and racing thoughts. And in emotional dimensions, we can see some reflections on the any educator who is working as a teacher, as a head teacher, as an administrator, and as a gatekeeper, whatever you say. For example, some reflections in the emotional dimensions, you can see, for example, feeling down, feeling overwhelmed, inability to relax. And also in the physical dimensions, these issues can be reflected by an educator or by some educators. Excessive perspiration, chest pains, frequent colds, illness, nausea, dizziness, or headaches. And in the fourth dimension, we call it as behavioral one, increase, decrease, appetite, nervous habits, and so on. Who are affected with the stress? Stress occurs when pressures or demands exceed our coping capacity and resources. Who is affected? Of course, teachers and the support staff, heads, managers, governors, and groups and management teams, everybody in the school. And what causes and effects of them? If we think about the causes and effects of the stress, probably we can see many things. If we talk about the causes, of course we know that teachers have many workloads, as you can see in this slide. Roles and responsibilities, over roles and responsibilities, and many kinds of relationships, and work cultures, trauma, and many times changing issues, legislations, regulations, principles, and the school probably management rules and personal life. And the effects, it, these causes can affect, may affect it, you know, the our emotional and physical health. For example, it can be reflected as mental health, We, as teachers, as administrators, our health can be affected, as can be seen in this slide. For example, mental health can be affected by the stress or with the stress, physical health, performance, relationships, and the group relationships and personal life, and also career life. These can be affected by the stress. Of course, managers and gatekeepers and teachers are human beings. If our teachers are human beings, the head teachers, the gatekeepers, administrators are also human beings. And these may cause the high level stress. For example, separation or loss, bereavement, redundancy, relocation, career change, family trauma, extended illness, crime or justice. I think it is stress. The cause is stress. There are many researches about stress and about teachers' stress, about head teachers' stress, about gatekeepers. We call it sometimes as gatekeepers in English term. British people say gatekeepers in generally, as you know, we think about head teachers, school administrators, and also managers. We call it in often time gatekeepers. We all have stress, colleagues and administrators. And a certain amount of stress is healthy. It allows the attentional center of brain. Educators can sometimes use stress to stimulate learning. Sometimes it is beneficial. It is beneficial, but sometimes it is not. If it is in the higher level, it is not beneficial. But sometimes this low level stress is sometimes beneficial. In the research report says that 65% of educators said workplace stress had caused difficulties. 40% of the educators said yelling and verbal abuse is common, and so on. You can see the slide in detail, but I should say that in the end, Turkish educators are working longer and harder. Yesterday, we found Mr. Seyid Ali Büyük, Konya Province Local Education Authority and Director. We called them to each other, and we speak to them. We speak to each other approximately 1 hour, and we said to each other, yes, we work longer time and hard time. Chronic stress can produce depression, violence and physical disabilities in teachers and administrators. This is the boredom of stress, and this is the high. If you see the slide, joy of stress is good, but you know the high level stress is not good. Excess or chronic stress. The impact of severe stress can cause on our emotions, on our thoughts, on our beliefs, on our, in short, lives. For example, feeling powerless, physical symptoms, neck and back problems, headaches, fatigue, sleeping issues, and also as emotional symptoms, anger, sadness, and depression. Excess stress inhibits learning and teaching process as well. Educators are often being expected to produce more results with fewer resources. Of course, with fewer resources, we are expected to, you know, the, increase the teaching and learning level. Problem of stress is very important. We shouldn't deny actually stress, but you know, we cannot ignore the stress as well. If you look at the, you know, the pictures, we have to think about these issues. Emotions, the critical force, content, process, context are important if we think about stress. And from where, how, and what, these are the important questions to ask ourselves. And we have to answer these questions as well. Probably, if you think about the strategies and the challenges about the stress, we have to, you know, say to ourselves, we are good enough, we are smart, smart enough, and gosh darn, and so on. Humor. Benefits to all. To all of the, all of us. There are many benefits from humor, coming from humor. For example, it maximizes brain capacity. Humor alerts the limbic system, the attentional center of the brain. And also, information is more likely to be remembered if it has meaning and contains an emotional hook. Humor gets attention. Humor, if we think about the humor, it gets benefit to us. For example, enhances creativity as well. It enhances creativity. And it facilitates communication. Humor provides insights into your own behavior and that of others. Humor is part of emotional intelligence. It is the ability to recognize our own emotions and the emotions of others and to respond with positive energy, humor. And sports, the humor, sports the change process. If you look at the, you know, the slide, fear and joy. What is the difference between them? Fear and joy. On the left hand side, there is fear. On the right hand side, there is a joy. As teachers, we have to do actually many things to get out the stress, to eliminate the stress, probably to reduce the stress level. Probably it is the, you know, true term, to reduce, to be able to reduce the stress level. We can do many things, but we can do, these are probably some principles. We can encourage exercise, water, healthy eating, and also we can choose some people for new positions that exhibit optimism. And also, we can monitor our own internal dialogue, and also we can find an optimistic partners or optimistic partners to support our efforts. In the stress reduction, we can also do these things. For example, we can recognize that thoughts impact our behavior and emotions. And also, we can focus on what is our control versus out of our control. And the strategies to reduce stress, I will talk about a few principles to get out the stress. And for example, we can exercise any activity that we can find enjoyable, and also we can create some good time each day to decompress. For example, we can write something which can be a story, which can be a poem, which can be any kind of a composition. And also, we can, you know, have some attention to the relaxation techniques, and we can apply some relaxation techniques as well. For example, we can imagine our thoughts floating away in a balloon. And also, muscle relaxation is very important to reduce the stress level. We can say, I am smart, I work hard, I always do my best. And also, we can say every time, I did a great job learning this new curriculum, and so on. Instead of criticizing ourselves, we can talk to ourselves as saying that I am smart, I work hard, I always do my best. That's enough. In summary, stress is a universal term actually. We can not definitely eliminate from ourselves, but we can reduce the stress level. And also, we know that chronic stress has serious consequences. And also, stress management often blames the victim. Individual change is possible through learned optimism and positive emotionality. And humor has many benefits that can reduce chronic stress. That's enough. That's all. Teşekkür ederim sabrınız için. Sağ olun. Thank you very much for your patience. Thank you.
Many thanks for Hakan Hocam to spend his special time, busy time for us for this project. And I invite Deputy Director of National Education Directorate, Servet Hocam, to present this special gift for the memory of this project and today.